So all these questions, multiple choice questions, so objective type questions are based on Jayant Mahapatra and his poem Hunger. Okay, so let us have a look at all the important questions for the examination. Jayant Mahapatra, he was given Padma Shri Award in 2009, and he also composes poetry in Oriya and in English. Jayant, the very first question is, Jayant Mahapatra was born in 1928. Okay, he was born in 1928. Jayant Mahapatra taught. This is very important question because it has been asked several times. It has appeared in several years and it is also being repeated that Jayant Mahapatra taught what? He taught physics. So never forget this answer. Jayant Mahapatra taught physics. Third one is, Mahapatra is called a late bloomer in poetry. A late bloomer in poetry. And this is also asked that Jayant Mahapatra is called. Fill in the blanks. So Jayant Mahapatra is called a late bloomer in poetry. So, like Shiva K. Kumar, like Shiv K. Kumar. But here the most important question is that Mahapatra is called. Then you will be given option and you have to learn this line, that a late bloomer in poetry. Next question is, which poem has been written by Mahapatra? It is Taste for Tomorrow. Taste for Tomorrow. This poem was also of Jayant Mahapatra. Sixth one, again very important. This one, sixth one. Which temple? Okay, it is also asked many times. It has come in the examination. Sixth one. Which temple town figures prominently in Mahapatra's poetry? Which temple town figures in his poem? And it is Puri. The answer is Puri. It is also very important. Puri temple town figures prominently in Mahapatra's poetry. The seventh one is, Mahapatra's first volume of poems was. Mahapatra's first volume of poems was Close the Sky 10 by 10. Close the Sky 10 by 10. It was the first volume of poems of Jayant Mahapatra. Next one is A Rain of Rights. It is, this poem is not in your syllabus, so you will never be asked such type of questions. So just leave them. And now come to the 10th one. 10th one, ignore this also, not important for you. 11th one is not important for you. Now it is Mahapatra's, this is important. Mahapatra's, Jayant Mahapatra's poetry is remarkable for. So all are the characteristics of his poetry, and you have to go through one by one. Depth of feelings and true poetic imagination. Love, sex and relationships. Super poetic craftsmanship. All of the above. Because we find all these qualities in the poetry of Jayant Mahapatra. So, our answer will be the last one, right? All of the above. And you have to look all these characteristics, what kind of relationship, what kind of craftsmanship, or the imagination of feelings, what kind of feelings and imagination we find in his poetry. Then, the next one is, Mahapatra's poetic sensibility is typically Indian. Mahapatra's poetic sensibility, because he is an Indo-Anglian poet, so his poetic sensibility is typically Indian, right? It is Indian. Next one is blank, then has a dominant presence in his poetry. Has a dominant presence in his poetry. So there is a dominance of, there is a presence of course, it is Orissa. It is Orissa landscape with firs and konarks. Orissa landscape with firs and konark has a dominant presence in his poetry. Then the 15th one is also important because it is also the theme of his poem Hunger. According to Mahapatra, prostitution and sexual exploitation results from what is the main cause of all this? So in his poem we also find this kind of theme, results of economic disparity, gross social injustice, upper apathy of politicians to utter apathy of politicians to public welfare, yes, all of the above, all of the above, that is economic disparity, gross social injustice, utter apathy of politicians to public welfare are the main reason of prostitution and sexual exploitation according to Mahapatra's poetry. Then 16th one is not important, and the 17th one, Mahapatra's images are, and the answer will be options: evocative, suggestive, haunting, precise and accurate. So all of the above. Jayant Mahapatra's images are evocative, haunting, suggestive, precise and accurate. So all the answers are right, and our answer will be all of the above, right? All of the above. The next question is, that is 18th one, and 18th one, it is also important. Which of the following is not the feature of Mahapatra's poetry? Which of the following is not the feature of Mahapatra's poetry? It is restrained and balanced. It has verbal excesses. It has no redundant expressions. It represents the Indian sensibility. So, which is not the feature of his poetry? It has verbal excesses. We don't find this kind of verbal excesses in his poetry. So, his poetry, it is restrained and balanced. It has no redundant expressions, and it represents the Indian sensibility. So, answer is here, it has verbal excesses because it is not the feature of his poetry. Now, the main theme, okay, most important question, what is the main theme of his poetry? The main themes of Mahapatra's poems are, then you have to go through all the options, yes, all are the main themes of his poems. The main themes of Mahapatra's poems are the Orissa landscape, history and culture, love, sex, sexuality, prostitution, poverty, contemporary reality. All are the main theme of his poetry. So, our answer will be all of the above. Next question is, it is not important, just ignore it. Next one is also not important. Then our next one is, okay, you can have a look. Then not even this, and the last one, no, not even the last one. But if you like, you can have a look on all these questions also, but according to me, these are not important for the examination. So, it will be better for you to ignore all of them. Now, just come at the text, that is Hunger, because Hunger, this poem has been prescribed in your syllabus. So, we have to look at all the important questions based on this poem Hunger. The very first question is, who composed the poem Hunger? Of course, Jayant Mahapatra. Okay, Jayant Mahapatra, he composed the poem Hunger. Jayant Mahapatra belongs to, that is, Cuttack, Orissa. He belongs to Orissa, Cuttack. Jayant Mahapatra received Padma Shri Award in which year? In 2009. And this is most important question because it is being asked for last many years that Jayant Mahapatra, he received what? So, first of all, that he received Padma Shri Award. And second question, that in which year he received this award? In 2009, right? So it is very important. Next one is, for many years Jayant Mahapatra brought out a literary magazine. For many years Jayant Mahapatra brought out a literary magazine. And what is the name of that magazine? That is Chandrabhaga. This is that literary magazine, Chandrabhaga. Next one is, Jayant Mahapatra has received the Sahitya Academy Award, right? He also received Padma Shri Award and he also received the Sahitya Academy Award. But for which book he got this award? For his book Relationship. Okay, Sahitya Academy Award was given to Jayant Mahapatra for this book Relationship. Next one is, besides English, Jayant Mahapatra also wrote in which language? In Oriya and in English he wrote. In Oriya, Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger is about what? What is the main theme of Hunger? Or what is the main content? That is, Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger is about what? About poverty and sexuality. Most important question, the theme of Hunger. It is poverty and sexuality. 31 question is, number of characters. How many characters are there in Hunger? So, number of characters, Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger. How many characters are there in this poem Hunger? Of course, there are only three characters. There are only three characters, the daughter, the girl, and her father, and the poet himself. So, there are only three characters. Then, next one is 32. The legs of the girl in Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger are compared to a. The legs of the girl are compared to, that is, to a worm. The legs of the girl in this poem Hunger are compared to a worm. Okay. Then the next one is, Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger is a poem, autobiographical of course. Jayant Mahapatra, because the writer or the person, the visitor who goes to the girl with her father, it was Jayant Mahapatra himself. So this poem Hunger is an autobiographical poem. Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger is a poem, autobiographical. Now the next question is important for the examination. Father in Jayant Mahapatra's poem Hunger is a, okay, what is the profession of the father of the girl, or what does he do in this poem Hunger? So father is a fisherman. Father is a fisherman. Next one is not important. Then 36th one. In which book Jayant Mahapatra poem Hunger first appeared? Okay, most important, that in which book for the first time this poem Hunger first appeared? The name of that book was A Rain of Rights. A Rain of Rights. This was the book in which for the first time this poem Hunger appeared. A Rain of Rights. Never forget this book. Then 37. not important. 38, 38, just no, leave it. 39, it is also not important. Then come to 40, 40, yes, it is important. Mahapatra's poem Hunger presents two kinds of hunger. Most important, this question is, Mahapatra's poem Hunger presents two kinds of hunger. Oh, that is, one is physical hunger and another is. So, you have to name the hunger of another one. That is, there are two kinds of hunger. The title of this poem is Hunger, but there are two kinds of hunger. The first one is physical hunger and the second one is, and the answer will be of course, sexual hunger. Okay? The first one, physical hunger, and another is sexual hunger. Now, 41 is also important. Mahapatra's poem Hunger primarily has two structures of images. Mahapatra's poem Hunger primarily has two structures, okay, two structures of images, one poverty related and another, one is related to poverty and another flesh related. Poverty related and another is flesh related. Next one is, what type of images are prepared by the phrases like the bone thrashing in his eyes, the bone thrashing in his eyes, images, trailing his nets and his nerves in the Mahapatra's poem Hunger. Images of helplessness. What type of images are prepared by the phrases like the bone thrashing in his eyes, helplessness, trailing his nets and his nerves, and here we find the images of helplessness. 43 question. It is also important. What type of images are prepared by the phrases like mind thumping in the flesh sling, palm fronts scratched my skin, and the images are images of wound here. Palm fronts scratched my skin, thumping in the flesh sling. Then next one is the suit image. In the third stanza of Mahapatra's poem Hunger is a customary suggestion of, so it is a suggestion of sin. Here we find this kind of suit image and it is a customary suggestion of sin because it was a sin. Then fourth, 45, this question, long and lean, her ears were cold as rubber. What meaning is conveyed here by cold as rubber? Okay, in which poem? In Hunger poem, called as rubber. So, what meaning is conveyed here? Her human sensitivity turned deaf and dumb. Dumb, that is long and lean. Her ears were cold as rubber. And the message, the meaning is here, in cold as rubber means her human sensitivity turned deaf and dumb. 46th one is, she opened her wormy legs wide. She opened her wormy legs wide. I felt the hunger there. What type of hunger is prominently indicated here? Of course, this kind of hunger was hunger of empty stomach. I felt the hunger there, hunger of empty stomach. The next question is 47. The sky fell on me and a father's exhausted wail. What meaning is more appropriately conveyed by sky fell on me? The sky fell on me. This phrase is very important. The sky fell on me and a father's exhausted wail. So here, wounded deeply by poor man's helplessness. What we find here? That is, wounded deeply by poor man's helplessness. Poor man, it was the father of the girl, the fisherman. And his helplessness is conveyed through this phrase, the sky fell on me and a father's exhausted wife. Next one is, what is more appropriate explanation of Mahapatra's poem Hunger in a Nutshell? Appropriate explanation. This poem is about the realization of helplessness. This poem is about, what is the main theme of this poem? That is the realization of helplessness, helplessness of poor person, of the father and of the girl. So this was the main theme of this poem, and this was the most appropriate explanation, we can say, in brief, in nutshell, the realization of helplessness. 41 is, the poem Hunger is remarkable for what? The poem Hunger is remarkable for precision and compactness, right? Precision and compactness. 51 is, in the poem, it is not important, just leave this, you can have a look. That is, hunger has been used in a double sense. And double sense, that is, the sharp desire to eat caused by starvation, the insatiable hunger for sexual satisfaction. Now, most important, another one is, the figure of speech in the word hunger is, the figure of speech in the word hunger is metaphor. Okay, it is metaphor. It is very important. And then next one is also, the poem Hunger is in the form of dramatic monologue, because there is only a visitor, there is only a poet, the poet, that is, and he tells us all the this kind of incident, what took place with him, what happened with him. So this poem Hunger is in the form of dramatic monologue because there is only one speaker. On what is the poem Hunger a satire? Hunger is a satire. Okay, this poem Hunger, of course, it is a satire, it is a criticism, but it is a satire on what? So it is a satire on poverty and social injustice. It is a satire on poverty and social injustice. So all these were important questions based on hunger poem, objective type questions or MCQ.